of finding the CSS selector to identify the web elements.
Regarding absolute and partial CSS selector, partial CSS selector is also called as a relative CSS selector. Format of a partial or relative CSS selector is as follows. You have a star sign followed by a square bracket. The square bracket has an attribute. The attribute is equal to the value of the attribute within single quotes. The star sign is nothing but it's a regular expression, which means any HTML tag. Attribute can be any attribute present in the HTML script. Absolute or full CSS selector always starts with the root tag. Root tag means the HTML tag. Firebug or the inspect element of tool always generates partial CSS selector by the ID attribute of the web element. If the ID of attribute is not present, then it will create the CSS selector by the class attribute. For ID attribute, as we have seen, it creates a hashtag followed by the value of the ID attribute. For class, it creates a dot followed by the value of the class. If a web element does not have an ID of attribute or the class attribute in the HTML script, then the firebug or the inspect element will show the absolute CSS selector from the root tag, that is from the HTML tag, or any other HTML tag present below the HTML tag. We see practicals of absolute or partial CSS selector. Now going back to the notepad that I'd opened, the notepad contains certain CSS selectors out here. The CSS selectors can be your, these are the CSS selectors which is shown by the inspect element tool of Chrome. So this is, I can call this as a partial or relative CSS selector. And I can call it partial or relative because it does not start with the HTML tag. If the CSS selector starts with the HTML tag, that means it's a absolute or a full CSS selector. This CSS selector is also a partial or relative CSS selector. So I can just copy this out here like this. Similarly, if you consider this particular CSS selector, this is also a partial or a relative CSS selector. Now consider this, these are for the Google edit boxes. These are for the Google search button. If you look at this also, this is also a partial or a relative CSS selector because the first tag is not an HTML tag. If the first tag is not an HTML tag, that means it's a partial or a relative CSS selector. So I can just write down as partial or relative. Similarly, if you look at this also, this is also a partial or relative CSS selector, and these two. Now we have seen the example of using these CSS selector as far as your practicalities are concerned. So I don't need to basically give the practicalities or demonstration of how to use this CSS selector which is present out here. Now a very important tip or note, generally the firebug of your Firefox or the inspect element tool of Chrome will show you the partial or the relative CSS selector if the HTML script of that web element contains the ID attribute or the class attribute. Okay, if the HTML script of the web element does not contain the class attribute or the ID attribute, it will take any other class attribute value or any other ID attribute value from the tags which are present above the tag for which we are trying to create a CSS selector. Okay, at any point of time, it is not able to create any partial CSS selector, then only it will create the absolute or the full CSS selector by starting the first tag with the HTML tag. Okay, so no other further practicalities needs to be given for absolute or partial CSS selector. Let's go to the next slide out here. The next slide speaks about the customized CSS selector. Now,